In this video, we are going to build a system for searching for other users. This is very important because later we're going to be building a friend request system. And unless you can go and like search for other users, there's no way to see their profile and no way to send them a friend request. So this is very important. So essentially what we want to build here is no matter what view we're at, we want this kind of search view at the top. If I was to search for another user, say, I'll just search J, so I'll get like a whole bunch of different results. I should get this view where I come up with all these results of users that have J in their name. And that's what we're going to be working on. That way I can click on one of these and later I'll be able to send them friend requests. So the first step here is going to be building the HTML view for all of those users. So let's go into account, go into templates and go to account and create a new file and press Control S to save. I'm going to call this search underscore results dot HTML. Now I don't want to type this out as always. I'm trying not to type out any HTML in the rest of this course, just JavaScript if I can help it. We have templates, account, search results dot HTML. And let's copy everything here. Now there's a lot and we're going to be going through it, so don't worry. So let's go up to the top. We have our basic Django kind of setup stuff, some basic CSS for styling. Again, you can check that out if you want. I'm not going to talk about it. We have a container, we have a card, and then inside of that card is going to be all of the kind of search results. So if we go back to the demo that I showed you at the beginning of this video, if I was to, you know, go up here and search for something, basically we have this card that outlines the entire view, and then within that we're going to have other cards for all of the users. So there's like a big outside card that kind of surrounds the whole thing, and then inside here is going to be individual cards for the users. So you can see like that's a card, this is a card, and they're grouped in twos. So if there was two results, it would show two users. But if there was actually only one result, let me close this. If there was one result, so if I searched Mitch, it's gonna occupy the whole view. But we have the same kind of system. We have a card on the outside, and then we have a card on the inside. So that's what we have here. So the search results will be right here. So for account in accounts, this is a Django loop. And then we wanna create that second card for that result. And that's what all of this kind of stuff is. The first thing here is the profile link. So this is how we would visit their profile. This is their account name. Remember that namespace and then URL for visiting their account. We set the user ID parameter. Now the thing that you might be confused about is this like dot zero. This is something that we're gonna talk about when we build the view in just a minute here. So like you're probably used to seeing like account dot ID. Well, what is this zero thing? Well, I'm actually accessing a list inside of the template, but I'm gonna come back and talk about that later. Then we have the profile image. And coming down, we have the profile link again here for their username. So it's just a href that's surrounding their username. Again, we have that zero notation, which I'm going to talk about when we take a look at the view. And then we have account.1. Well, what is account.1? Again, we're referencing a list through the template. So I'm going to be talking about what account.1 is, what account.0 is, when we build that template or when we build that view. Now this is the link to send them a message. So if I go back to the demo here again, if I was to search a user who I'm friends with, say Jess, see notice that I'm friends with Jess. So this view changes depending on if, oh, there's actually a user named Jess and one named Jessica, interesting. So I'm not friends with Jess, but I am friends with Jessica. So it shows that I'm friends, it shows a little green check mark, shows I'm not friends, and it shows an X. Down here is a send message link. That's this right here. So it's gonna execute a JavaScript function called create or return a private chat. This does not exist yet. This is gonna be built later when we actually build the private chat messaging system. This is basically just a placeholder for now. So you can just treat this as a placeholder. It doesn't do anything. Then as we come down, we've got the logic for showing like, are we friends or are we not friends? That's what this section is here. So again, we're gonna talk about this when I build the Django view. So account.1, you can probably assume that this means, this is a Boolean. This is gonna mean, yes, we are friends. If this is true, we show the check mark. If that is false and it is not the authenticated user, so it's not the user that, it's not me who's looking at this myself, then it just shows that you are not friends. So basically, are we friends? Yes, show the check mark. Are we not friends? Then no, don't show the check mark. And that's these two different cases here. This is actually a perfect view for describing this. Are we friends? Yes. If not, no. That's gonna be this case over here. Now, otherwise, there's a third case. So it's kind of like there's three cases here. Are you friends? Not friends. And then there's a third case down here for if we are not friends, but it is the authenticated user. That's like if I was to search my own user, and this is me authenticated, we're not friends, but so it doesn't show the check mark or the X, but it's me. So it shows this third case, and it should say that this is you. And that's what we see here in the HTML. This is you, and it shows a person kind of icon. So those are the three cases for the right-hand side. Now, this logic here is some logic for splitting it up into sets of two. So remember, if I search here and I just search for like J, these are all split up in entries of two. So there's two at the top, two, 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 and they go all the way down to two until there's an odd number. And then that odd number will occupy the entire kind of width. That's what this does here. So inside of the loop, I wrote an if statement that says, for loop counter. So that's in Django language, how to access the current loop index, for loop.counter. If that counter is divisible by two, then I want to close that div and I want to create a new one. So that's how I'm splitting this up into groups of two. So if the for loop counter is divisible by two, so this would be like one, two, then split it and go to the next one. Three, four, split it, go to the next one, and so on. So that's how we set that up. Now down at the bottom, we just have no results. So if I was to, so basically if there are no friends. So this else statement is, if I go all the way to the top, the else for this right here. So if accounts, I should actually maybe tab this out so you can see that a little better. So this else is for this if statement here. So if there are search results, if there are accounts from searching, then loop through them and do your thing. Otherwise, I want to show something that says no results. So what does no results look like? Let's search something that is very obscure. And there we go. That would be no results. So there's no users with that in their username or their email. Now, if I scroll down to the bottom here, we have a template or an HTML file that is not being included. Notice that it's being commented out here. And this is the one that's going to contain that JavaScript function that I mentioned up here. Create or return private chat. Now, I said earlier that this doesn't exist yet. This is for when we actually do create the friend system. I think I actually said that this would contain this function. Obviously, that's not true. The function's right here. This would contain logic that gets executed that's inside of this template. So this is just commented out. This does nothing. These are placeholders for later. Okay, that's the HTML. Now let's build the view. So press Control S, go to views.py, and I'm going to scroll down to the bottom, and we're going to create that account search view. So define account search view, all lowercase, and request arguments, keyword arguments. I want to get a context variable like we always do. I'll just do return render request. This will be account and then search results.html and then just return that context. So now in between here is all the logic for the template variables that we're going to be returning to search results.html. So first of all, if request.method equals get, and a get request will be executed by default when we go into here and we actually like if I search something that executes a get request. So that's what we're checking for here. So now I want to get the search query from the keyword arguments. So I can say search query equals request.get.get. You could also get it from the keyword arguments. So I'm searching for that variable q. So if we go to openchat.xyz, notice that it does question mark q and then whatever the search is. So if I'm searching for a user named Mitch, q equals Mitch. If I'm searching for J, q equals J. So that's what I'm getting out of that request. I'm extracting it. Now I want to do some quick check. I want to make sure that the search query is greater, or the length of the search query is greater than zero, so they're not just searching for nothing. And in that case, I want to set the search results to something. So I want to search for the accounts. So account.objects.filter. Now, previously, or I guess up to now, we've only seen the get function. Now we're using a filter function. The filter function will return a query set, so it could return multiple rows from the database. Get will return a single row. So we're using filter to return multiple rows. And I'm going to use email underscore underscore I contains equals the search query. So the notation here is the field name. I'm looking for the field email in account underscore underscore I contains. This is, you can also use contains. I'm using I contains. I contains means don't consider uppercase or lowercase. It doesn't matter if it's uppercase or lowercase, just search using that text. Contains would take into consideration if it was uppercase or lowercase. So I don't care about uppercase or lowercase, so I'm using I contains. Now I want to apply a second filter. So not only do I want to filter on the email, I'm going to paste that in, and that should have actually wrapped to the next line. There we go. I want to filter on the username. So I'm going to do the username field, I contains search query. So if the email contains the search text, or if the username contains the search text, that is what I'm looking after. Now I could return multiple results potentially. For example, if I go to openchat.xyz and I search for Mitch, well, both my username and my email contain Mitch. So that would return two results. Well, we don't want that. So what we can do is apply the distinct operator on this to eliminate duplicate results. And that's gonna be our search query. Now we want to determine if any of these results is the authenticated user. So like in the results here, Mitch, this is me, so I need to know that. I also want to determine if we're friends or if we are not friends. Now the friend system isn't set up yet, so more or less I'm just gonna have like a placeholder system here for now. But we still can determine if the authenticated user is one of the search results, but we don't have the ability to determine if they're friends yet, but that will come later. So the way we're gonna do this is I'm gonna create a list named accounts, and you probably saw this inside of the template. Notice that all the variable is one of the variables is accounts. So this is the thing that we're gonna be looping through. So I'm creating a list, and the structure of this list is gonna be like so. So it's gonna have like each entry in the list will contain an account. So I'll say like account number one, and then a Boolean true or false, depending on are they your friend or are they not your friend. So that's the structure of this list that we're going to return to the template. So like this would be account number two, and then maybe they're not your friend, and then so on and so on. That's gonna be the structure of this list. That's gonna make it really easy here for when we, you know, make a search. Here's like all their information, then are we friends or not, just a Boolean, yes or no. And like it would change depending on obviously if they are your friend or they're not. So how can we do this in the view? So there is the list that I've defined. Now I wanna loop through the search results. So I can say for account in the search results, that's just gonna return a query set of accounts that match those search results. So I'm gonna say accounts dot append. That's how you add things to a list in Python, you call append. Now I wanna add an entry. So I wanna add the account and then whether or not we are friends or not. Well, in this case, like I said, we don't have the friend system set up yet. So I'm just gonna put false for every single one of these. Everybody is not my friend. So I'll write a little comment here saying, you have no friends. And later you might have some friends, but right now you have no friends. So now I'm gonna add that variable to the context. So I'm gonna say accounts equals that accounts variable, that accounts list. I think earlier I said that we were going to do something in the list that determines whether to say like this is you or not. So like in the search results here, if it's me, it shows here. This is actually done in the template. It's not done in the view. So sorry if I confused you. This variable actually is not going to be used yet, but that's going to, I could just remove it now just to get rid of any confusion you might have. That's going to be used later when we do the determine if they're friends or not. We need obviously access to the authenticated user's account and then determine if this account is their friend or not and set the Boolean. But that's going to be all done later. So for now, that is going to be our account search view. So making sure to press Control S on that to save it. And we're going to add this URL to the top level urls.py file. So go into account.views and do account search view. So just importing that view that we just built. And let's add this. So it's going to be in alphabetical order. So after register, this is just going to be search. You could do account search. You could write whatever you want technically. Account search view, and this will be, the name will be search. Okay, now how do we use this? How do we execute this? Well, we need to go into headers.html, or header.html. Now, all we need to do is actually go to the very bottom, and we are going to add some JavaScript. So add a script tag, and we need to create a function called execute query. I swear I had this already, but that's fine, whatever. Now I want to get a variable named query. This is how you define a variable in JavaScript, var query, and then set it equal to nothing. I can actually just say document.getElement, get element by ID, and do id queue small. I'll talk about where that's coming from in just a second, and then call dot value. You can add a semicolon here or not. Usually modern browsers don't require it. It's fine. Now if the query, so query equals nothing, in that case, we know we're actually on a large screen because this ID is different. So I'll actually just explain that really quick. So if we go up to the top here and go to the very first search form, notice that this one is ID queue large because this is our medium plus screens. And then if I scroll down, we have small screens and we have ID queue small. So there's two different search views. You have to do this because we can't have elements share the same ID in an HTML file. So the JavaScript just won't know which one to grab. So I named the small one a different name than the big one. So basically what we do is we check, is the small one empty? If the small one is empty, then we know that we're actually looking at a big screen. So I would say ID queue large and then dot value. So if there's no small value, then get the big value. Then we want to do window dot location dot replace. So this is going to change the URL. And then I can use some Django here and reference our search URL. So URL, search, and then I want to append that queue. So queue equals to the query. So plus query. So now this function, we want to execute it when the form is submitted. So if we go up to our forms, we want to execute this when the form is submitted. So I can say on submit equals return execute query, execute query. And because we're returning something, we want to return a Boolean from this function actually also. So return, okay, so going up to the top, I'm just gonna copy this on submit and go up to our other form up at the top here and do the same thing. So when this form is submitted, it will then execute our query, which is going to change the URL to our search URL. So it's gonna load the search view and set a queue parameter to whatever that query is. So I'm gonna press Control S on that and let's go to our development environment and let's refresh it. Let's go to the home screen and let's search for Mitch. So if I go to Mitch, that does not work. Oh, looks like I made a mistake. Inside of the form, actually, you want the on submit to be on the form itself. You don't want it to be on the input. So putting on submit onto the form there and scrolling down to the other form and getting rid of that, putting that in the form, saving that. And I forgot something very important. We have to actually assign this variable after we check if it's empty. Otherwise, obviously this is not gonna work. Okay, so pressing Control S, going to our development environment. I'm gonna search for the user Mitch and boom, there we go, there's Mitch. Now if I search for Jay, I get the user Jess. Now I don't have very many users on this server right now, so I can't search for a bunch. I don't think there's any that share any letters. Maybe E, yeah, there we go. That'll get Blake and Jess. But you can see here that yes, our searching is working correctly. Also, if I click on one of their profiles, that does take me to the correct profile. There's the user Blake. If I go back, I click on Jess, that takes me to Jess's profile. I can also go to visit my own. So if I search for Mitch, it says, this is me. Great. If I click here, yes, this is my profile. So all of that is working correctly. So again, there's still a lot of work to be done here. We don't have the friend system in place, so we can't determine, you know, if we're friends, if they're not, sending friend requests, receiving them, displaying in the search view whether we're friends or not, all that kind of stuff, but we are moving in the right direction. There's a lot of bread to bake, so to speak. We got a lot of work to do still. So in the next video, what we're going to do is work on updating the account. So if you're viewing your own account, when you click on update, it should take you to another page where you can now update your email, your username, hide the email, and also crop the profile picture and pick a new profile picture. I will see you in that next video.